Okay, this is better.
Hey!
Hi, Matt here. Welcome to my channel. No, sorry, go ahead.
We've been married a long time. Yes.
Wait, I'm.
Why are you?
Because now we're even in there.
Hey everyone, Christine, I see you here, and welcome back to our channel. This is my husband Matt, and we are back here for the van series. The reason why we're laughing, or prior to this, is we have a house full of pets right now, and it's cats, dogs, and a bird, and.
Somebody's knocking the camera over, or making a bunch of noise.
Eating the tripod.
Right, so.
Clicking on the floor. But yeah, but today's episode, episode 3, go check out the other two. Today is about what we want in our future vehicle, our future traveling vehicle. I particularly want to be able to stand up, walk through, while he's driving, and I can actually go either get lay down in the back or go get some fruit or something, just to have that room to walk around for just a little bit, and then also lay down on the being able to lay down while he's driving on the passenger side, so there has to be room to be able to move that chair. Light is a big deal for me. I need light, skylight, side lights, whatever it is. I need that light to be able to not feel like I'm in a box. Storage. To fit in luggage, because we do go to destinations, so it's like a VRBO, hotel, resort, whatever it is. I want to be able to just grab my luggage or bag and then get there. Wi-Fi, a workspace. If we're traveling, I want to be able to send you a video, so I want Wi-Fi availability, because this is not my full-time job. That's why I was late, sorry. Cooktop, mm-hmm. Be able to cook something just in case, whatever strikes our mood. If we want to cook a stir fry or something, we could.
Enough refrigerator and freezer space.
Yep. Storage for the stuff that we want to keep in the van or whatever.
You want to be able to live out of both. You want to have stuff in the van to live out of that when you're in the van.
Mm-hmm.
And then enough space for a luggage that you can take that separately, not have to repack everything up.
Right.
If we're going to go into a hotel or VRBO.
TV is optional. We found out that we really don't watch a lot of TV while traveling. We are more on our phones or iPads and computers than anything. Nooks and crannies for all the little gadgets I want to. It's my tech. So,
mm-hmm.
Hold on. Be right back. And we're back. Had to change the battery. Whew. Too many animals going around right now. Okay. Your turn.
Okay. So things that are important to me is I would like this van to be as short as possible. I would like it to be 18 foot, 20 foot at the most, and that's so we can fit it in a regular parking space. One of the big advantages of the minivan that we found is we can drive it anywhere, into the city, into pretty much any destination. I realize this a Class B is going to be taller, so there's no way that we're going to go into, you know, parking garages, things like that, but I would like to be short enough that we can fit in regular parking spaces. So that's one. It needs to be able to tow 5,000 pounds. I need to be able to tow the trailer and the car with it. Depending on how much racing I'm gonna do, this is gonna replace the big motorhome, so we have to be able to tow like we do with the big motorhome. So that's important. I would like it to have enough space, again, for both of us to be comfortable, but I would like a front living space. I would, instead of having the bed in the back and the kitchen and the bathroom up front, I want the living space up front, so when you have the slider open and or when you have the front open, it is more open that way. It has more room, it feels like it does at least.
Mm-hmm.
Even though obviously the floor footprint's the same, but I would like to have front living space. I would like to have a fixed bed or at least a bed that converts very easily. I don't want to have to put it up and down every single day. I don't want to have to take all the cushions from everything that we have and put it together to make a bed out of it, just because it takes a lot of extra time and we travel and move daily most of the time. And so I just don't want to have to pull that up and down every single day. I would like heat and air conditioning. It's a little uncomfortable in the van. We don't have quite the ventilation that I would like. Obviously, those are solvable even in the minivan, but I would like to have a nice heating system, air conditioning, some sort of vent system.
Okay.
That would be important also. A bathroom. We normally are staying at places where we have a bathroom, whether it be a campground or whether it's going to be rest area,
right.
Things like that. So, but there are times where we go where we don't necessarily have a great bathroom. So I would like to have the option to have a bathroom, even if it's portable. I would definitely like the option to shower, just because I wouldn't mind staying in some of the parks for a few more days, and some of the parks don't always have a shower that you can use. So to be able to shower off, and again, it doesn't have to be a full fixed spot. I think I would give up having a fixed bathroom, have a convertible bathroom, just because of the fact that it would take up a lot more space. We could have a 20 instead of a 24 foot long van and not have a fixed bathroom.
Is your own gas?
Well, it'll be, the van might be a little cheaper. It probably would get a little better gas mileage because it's lighter. Again, but it's easier to park and easier to get around. You'd be able to drive it easier.
Yes.
But the backup camera and side view cameras for driving, but also be able to turn them on in the back so we can see around the van at night. So sometimes when someone pulls in next to you or you hear people walking around, it'd be nice to be able to peek at it without having to open up the shades and look outside. So I'd like to have that also.
Okay.
So those are the things kind of just in general that are important. The question is going to come is whether we can fit that all in a van or not, or whether we can find it. You know, build right. versus buy. Obviously buying one would be nice because we don't have to convert. Right. Or whether we can find all that. Or if, even if we're going to build it, can we fit all that in there? I'm not sure yet.
That's true. But I think we can.
We're going to try.
Hopefully you can relate to some of the things that we're looking for in a van build. Sorry for the shakiness. Now the... Sorry. Wow. Okay. It's okay.
Good girl, Luna. Get the cat.
The cat was about to attack the camera. Just to finish this off and end this video, thank you for being here. Hit that like and subscribe button, because we'd sure like to have you back here on our next episode, where we're gonna actually go over options and what is actually out there. We've done a lot of researching. Hopefully you might find interest in. We'll see you later. Bye. So if we're not exactly big eaters, well, I am.
Not saying a word.
We should just vlog this whole week. Wow. So many distractions. But.